Today we'll be replacing the cabin fan blower motor of the Saab 9-3, and the reason I'll be doing that is that it has a hard time spinning up. This is the actual old part that I already took out because I'm recording this intro after replacing it, so you can immediately see that this is not what it should look like. And just to be honest, the new replacement part will not spin as freely as you might imagine it to do because, well, the motor is there, of course, but it's definitely better than this old one. When replacing it, there are a couple of things to take into account. The first is that it is mounted with 7 screws, which you can actually see if I hold it up. And some of them are in very awkward locations. The most difficult ones are these and these, and especially the one in the back, and this one, because there is not a lot of space. As you can imagine, this is in the back of the car, and there is, of course, where your foot rests, basically. It's sort of a slope, and it's fairly difficult to get a screwdriver in there. So that's why I use this ratchet type thing. So it's a very small ratchet which fits beautifully and actually works quite well. It's fairly easy to forget one of these 7 screws, as I did in my first attempt. Therefore, it makes sense to keep the new part handy so that you can refer to the screw mounting positions and, well, not forget it like I did. Also, there are 2 fastening clips, here and here. And this is a difficult one, there's this sort of indentation in which the cabin fan blower motor actually fits sort of the end on the car. So basically what you do is you put this next to the lip and you click it up basically, so it sort of snaps into place. You have to make sure that the clips also align because those have a tendency to sort of misalign. But as soon as you do that, you can actually sort of apply the screws again. Now I have a short clip in which you hear the blower motor having difficulty to maintain a steady RPM. First, we're going to remove the glove box. The easiest way to start is to remove the plastic piece wedged in between the glove box and the door. I actually forgot that, so you'll see it popping off at a later time, but it's easier to do it right at the beginning. The second thing we'll do is unscrew 5 screws. First, open the glove box and you'll see the first 2 screws on the left and the right side. There's also a 3rd one in the middle inside of the glove box, which is missing in my car, but normally there is one, so unscrew that as well. Then there are 2 screws on the bottom of the glove box, which you can unscrew when you close the glove box again, so you have access to those mounting points. Now it's time to take out the glove box. Unplug the 2 connectors that feed the glove box light, and make sure to pop off the hose that feeds cold air to the glove box. Not all cars have it. If you have it, you can just pull it off and it's fine. Now place the glove box in a safe location and we can continue with the next step. Next, we'll have to undo the trim piece on the middle console. The reason we are doing that is there is an air duct behind it, which is mounted on the blower motor, so we have to remove that. The trim piece is secured with a Torx 25 and possibly a screw cover, both of which are missing from my car. As soon as the screw is gone, you can just pull down and then back the plastic piece, which will reveal the clip with which it is attached to the car on the back side. Now we're removing the plastic part on the bottom of the ventilator. It's attached with 2 screws, one on the middle console side, so it mounts sideways, and one which mounts the plastic part to the ventilator, so also unscrew that. As soon as you unscrew the part, take it out by wedging it a little and it should come out fairly easily. Now we'll be removing the air duct. It's secured by a Torx 20 and mounted onto the ventilator. So unscrew that and just pop off the air duct by pulling it towards the right side. Now do some advanced wedging to get the air duct to come loose, pull it towards you and put it somewhere safe. Now it's finally time to undo the 7 screws. Again, some of them are fairly hard to reach, so it makes sense to have different sizes of screwdrivers at hand and also a small ratchet for the screw on the back side. I sped up the process somewhat because this is fairly boring to look at and it will take you, especially the first time, quite a long time to locate all the screws. Again, keep the new part handy so you can refer to where the screws should be and it is a lot easier to find them. Now that all 7 screws are undone, it's time to take out the blower motor. You do this by unhooking the 2 fastening clips and pulling the entire assembly down. It should come out fairly easily, but will take some force. Detach the connector and now the motor should be entirely free. Now it's time to transfer the regulator from the old motor to the new motor. It's an easy job, just 2 screws, pull the part out, and you can reattach it to the new blower motor. Now it's time to reinstall the blower motor. Although it is a good idea to plug it in, start the car, and see if it turns on at all. If it does, just shove it back into place, and this is the tedious part because you have to align the lip perfectly. Also, make sure the two fastening clips are aligned correctly. As soon as this is done, you can start re-screwing the 7 screws that you previously took out. And again, some are fairly difficult to reach, so this takes a long time and I sped it up for your viewing pleasure. Now make sure that all 7 screws are screwed in again, that the lip aligns correctly, and that the fastening clips align correctly as well. Also make sure that it's plugged in again. Then, as they say, to reassemble, follow these instructions in reverse order. First, we're going to reinstall the air duct using the one screw that mounts it to the ventilator. Be sure to pop it back into place on the middle console part. Then we'll reinstall the plastic bottom part that's below the ventilator. It uses two screws, one on the left side that mounts it to the middle console, and one somewhere in the middle on the bottom that mounts it to the ventilator. It's time to reinstall the trim piece that mounts to the center console. I've conveniently forgot to film this, but it's fairly easy. There's this plastic hook on the back side of the plastic piece, which attaches to a metal hook in the center console near the footwell. Use the screw, and if you have it, the screw cover to finish this part of the installation. Now it's time to reinstall the glove box. Make sure that you reattach the light connectors and also the cold air hose if you have it. And my apologies for the filming quality. By this time it was late at night and my camera had difficulty finding focus and decided not to focus at all. I hope it still helps. Refit the 5 screws that hold the glove box. The 2 on the left and the right side when you open the glove box, as well as the one in the middle, and the 2 on the bottom of the glove box, which you can access as soon as the glove box is closed. As the finishing touch, reseat the plastic piece between the door and the glove box. Again, I forgot to film this, but it should be very easy. This was a successful job for me, as you can hear when I turn on the blower motor. Done.